Hear God say to you now, Your sins are forgiven for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Let us sing our creedal song together.
Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, I did not call my son, lie down again. Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time, and he got up and went to Eli and said, Here I am, for you called me. Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, Samuel, Samuel. And Samuel said, Speak, for your servant is listening. Then the Lord said to Samuel, See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make both ears of anyone who hears of it tingle. On that day I will fulfill against Eli all that I have spoken concerning his house from the beginning to the end. For I have told him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God, and he did not restrain them. Therefore I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be expiated by sacrifice or offering forever. Samuel lay there until morning. Then he opened the doors of the house of the Lord. Samuel was afraid to tell the vision to Eli. But Eli called Samuel and said, Samuel, my son. He said, Here I am. Eli said, What was it that he told you? Do not hide it from me. May God do so to you and more also, if you hide anything from me of all that he told you. So Samuel told him everything and hid nothing from him. Then he said, It is the Lord. Let him do what seems good to him. As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel from Dan to Beersheba knew that Samuel was a trustworthy prophet of the Lord. Here ends the reading.
Please sing with us.
Thank you.
Gracious God, we give you thanks for your voice. We give you thanks for your calling. We give you thanks for your Son whom you sent out to be with us. Help open our ears. Help open our minds. Help open our hearts to be available to your call. You have a call for each of us, and help us to respond to that call. We lift all this up to you through your Son who came here to be with us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, guys, take care of your bulletins. You get some crayons over there. They're right over there. You can color them. And you can stay there if you like. I keep asking you guys to stay, but nobody stays. So in Samuel, do you hear how that reading starts out? The word of the Lord wasn't heard that often in those days. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were rare. Hearing the Lord was rare. It almost seems like maybe they were talking about today. We had this time when Jesus was on earth, and we hear about these different miracles that happen, healings, the baptism, heavens opened up, the Holy Spirit descended upon Jesus like a dove. I mean, you can't deny those things, right? You see them, you hear about them, those things happen. But here, we're hearing that it wasn't prevalent, it didn't happen often. So when's the last time somebody saw the heavens open up? How about the last time you heard God speaking to you? Nobody? Oh, I know that some people have heard God speaking. They just may not be raising their hands. Because God is speaking all the time. All the time. Here's something interesting. Now, it's Jewish humor, so you have to kind of go with it. You're going to have to just trust me a little bit on this. All right? Somehow, okay, right? Somehow I got something wrong. I am on the wrong page here altogether, so give me just a moment. My fingers slipped when I picked up my tablet. Now, okay, this is God's humor right now. Samuel, okay? Samuel. God hears. God hears him, okay? Hear God now. It's amazing. God is speaking continually. Samuel, and God is there speaking. He hears him. He hears him. But when he hears, when Samuel hears this, who does he go to? He goes to Eli. Well, here's the other piece of the humor. What does Eli say? My God. He goes to the wrong guy. He goes to the wrong person. A little bit of humor in here. He hears God speak, and he goes to the wrong one. He responds to the wrong person. That takes him a few tries before it gets straightened out. That's kind of like we ask most pastors when they get called into ministry, they usually are like, no, I didn't hear that. No. For me, it's like the holy 2x4, 4x4, and the 8x8. Then I understood a little bit. I identify with this particular section a lot. That's why the song today, too, is that I. We've all been called. God continues calling us. Continually calls us. But do we hear it? Or do we ignore it? God's calling each of us here right now to be involved in some way and respond to God. Do you believe that? Get you on the spot there, didn't I? God is calling you. Close one door, open another. God is calling you and you. God is calling all of us to do something. Now, there's another song we could have done, do something. But God is calling us to do something. But are we hearing him? Is God really silent, or is it that our ears are silent? And what did God say? He's going to do something that's going to cause both ears to tingle. Now, tell me the last time you got to hear tingle in the Bible. You don't get to hear that one too often, right? What they're talking about, you look this up, tingling, the tingling they're talking about is something so intense, like if you took somebody and went on both of their ears at the same time. Shaking, tingles. Listen, pay attention. This is going to turn everything around. That's the kind of tingling we're talking about. And who comes later? Jesus does. God comes. God comes down, takes on human flesh to walk with us. Now, if that ain't tingling of the ears, I don't know what is. That is tingling of the ears right there. Now, you'd think, though, that based upon the reading, that it was going to happen right away. But what's God's right away? What's our impatient right away? We tend to be a bit impatient. Maybe God was taking a rest. After 6 days of creation, you have to take a rest too, right? You can take a rest in between. But we're paying attention, listening, because he told Samuel that this is going to happen. And now we have the opportunity, because Jesus came, to experience that tingling. We still do today. God is still speaking today. God is not silent. God is never silent. Sometimes we think God is silent, but God speaks to us through our neighbors. God speaks to us through dreams. God speaks to us sometimes right out loud. Whatever opportunity that we give God. Now, I got my daughter here, and she remembers this. Do you remember the time we were driving in the car? Yeah. So I was on internship. But I was supposed to be supply preaching at my home church while I was on internship, and I wanted to know what was I going to preach about. Because the way this pastor decided to do it was he said, you pick what you want to preach on, you tell me the scripture. Now, thanks a lot. That's a lot of work. So I sit and pray about this. We're driving along, trying to figure out, what am I going to preach on? What am I going to preach on? And all of a sudden I heard the Holy Spirit, clear as day. And I looked over, because we didn't have the radio, and I said, did you say something? No. That's strange. Are you sure you didn't say something? No. God speaks. Sometimes like that. Sometimes it's from a song. Sometimes it's in a prayer, and then you get the song. I didn't make that prayer. That was part of Sundays and Seasons. I couldn't have been that creative.
Yeah.
But God can. God is speaking, but are we paying attention to it? That's the key. Are we paying attention to what God is calling us to do? Samuel was, after the third time. But then we get in and we hear Jesus calling his disciples. And somebody responds, come and see. They respond to God. Can you imagine if every person started from here over and all the way back, every person here could respond that way to God. Just the moment's notice. Do you imagine the change that would happen in Zealand? Can you imagine that? It would be awesome. It would be awesome that we just say, yeah, okay, let's go do it. What do you want me to do, God? But we have to hear it. And God is doing that. We are responding. We are part of things. But we can be part of a whole lot more. God keeps calling us into a whole lot more. Things are changing here. Haven't they been? Yeah. Things have been changing here. You're going to see it soon, but the number of new members that we've had over the last year far outweighs the number of people who died in this congregation. The number of baptisms that we had in this last year, something around 18 or more. And we already did another baptism last weekend. And we've got more that that want to be members. Matter of fact, we've got more people that want to be members, don't we? We've got more people that want to be members and talk to me about a baptism. So we have it going on right now. People are listening, people are responding, and they want to be part of this. Part of what you are part of. Part of what God is calling you to be part of. Part of what God is calling us all to be part of. So that we can respond. So we can drop everything. Hard to drop everything, isn't it? It is. But first we have to hear the call. The call can be simply sitting at the welcome center. Okay, as I got somebody here that sits at the welcome center. The call can be on council or another person at the welcome center. Or going over and taking communion to people over at the nursing home to sit on council, to fill in for ushers when we don't have ushers, or to be communion systems when we don't have somebody, or to be communion systems, or take care of the altar, or food bank, food pantry, or share the giving tree, the circles, the quilts, the prayer shawl ministry. And now, if you haven't seen them, and actually that's kind of a rhetorical question because I know that most of you have, because we have prayer patches out there and we can't keep them in the basket. They keep going out of the basket almost faster than we can put them in the basket. Put 20 in and end up with 2 the next Sunday. We have all these things that have an impact upon everybody that we meet. And that is through God's calling. So, is God silent? No. Sometimes we are. That was part of our confession today, too. Part of the confession of not responding to others, but also about ourselves. God loves us as we are. God calls us to be more. And God thinks of us far better than we often think of ourselves. God is not silent. God is calling. Are you responding? And what else can you respond to? Please rise as you're able. Confident that God, our life and our salvation, hears us when we pray, let us offer our prayers for the church, the world, all people in need. For the church throughout the world and for all called to its various ministries, that the Holy Spirit invited us and others to come and see, let us pray. For the well-being of creation, for plants that provide nourishment, for animals that tend their young, that your goodness will be revealed through all creation. Let us pray. For the nations and all authority, for advocates, for those who work for all injustices, for our community, and all the people that may thrive together in harmony and order, let us pray. For all who are oppressed, for those who suffer as body, mind, or spirit, for the caregivers and families, for those who grieve and cannot sleep, that comfort will come to those in any distress. Let us pray. For those upon our prayer list who need your healing, some in body, some in mind, and some in spirit, we lift them up to you. Today, we lift up Diane. who is battling cancer, with your help, Lord. And Melissa, who is also battling cancer, with your help. We ask that you be with the family of Annabelle, who recently died. Comfort and guide them all. Be with Gary, and be with baby Connor, who has recovered from RSV and from pneumonia, but still needs to remain healthy as he prepares. As a baby, he prepares for a transplant. Be with Jerry as he continues to recover from his surgery. Be with Bubba and Arlene as they battle their colds. Be with Crystal and Bill and her yet unborn baby. Be with Alice as she fights a kidney infection. And Amy as she fights to get well from pneumonia. Be with Bill as he continues to recover after his surgery, is getting stronger and able to walk longer. We give you thanks, O Lord, for Gracie's birth, her new daughter. The whole Troutline family, we give us thanks. We ask you to continue to watch over them as Gracie continues to recover from the C-section. But we give you thanks for a healthy girl that was born. We ask that you watch over the family of Rick, whose father recently died. Be with them, comfort them, and guide them. We also ask you to be with the family of Winetta Kleinberg, who died yesterday evening. Comfort them and guide them as they prepare to bury her. Be with John as he's at home, trying to get healthy from pneumonia. He wanted to come in, but he knew it was better to stay home. Be with him and his caregivers. Lord, we also lift up to you all those that are upon our hearts that we say out loud or silently. Waco, Savita, let us pray. In thanksgiving for those who follow Christ and now rest from their labors, that their witnesses provide a model of prophetic leadership and tireless justice making, let us pray. Merciful God, you hear our prayers even before we speak them. You know what is written upon our hearts and our minds. Receive those prayers. Receive them for the sake of the one whom through you have revealed your goodness, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated. We'll take up today's offering. So I have a couple of announcements. Share, I need a couple volunteers to help unload the share truck when it arrives on Saturday the 20th at 8 o'clock. So if you could assist on that, that would be appreciated. Prayer Shawl Ministry is back onto its regular schedule. So Tuesdays and Saturdays, so we'd love to join into that again. We have a council meeting today following this service, so council members, be there, and if you aren't here, hopefully you're coming back. So be there for that. Also, our annual meeting is January 28th. Don't forget about that. We have that coming up. That'll be at 11:30. We have a constitutional changes forum because we have some changes that are mandated that we need to do. So that will be on January 25th at 7 p.m. right here. And we also have a budget forum. That will be held on the 21st, which is next weekend. And are you the one doing it? Sue Hunter will be doing the budget forum, and it'll be done between the two services. So please be here if you have any questions about the budget. Are there any announcements I forgot to lift up?
Don't forget you have the election of council members at the annual meeting.
Yeah, we have six vacancies, we have nine people running. So, whoo! So, and it's not too late to get on the ballot, so if you'd like to, go ahead. More people to marry. So, I think we're ready for a song.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm living for the first time.